Dolores Robinson came to see Mercy Medical Center vascular surgeon Dr. Curtis Kim, concerned about pain and swelling in her left leg.
I had the swelling in the ankle and the leg, and I also had experienced extreme fatigue and loss of appetite, and I knew my body wasn't feeling well.
Dr. Kim diagnosed her with May-Thurner syndrome. It's an anatomical problem with the iliac vein and artery.
The arteries and veins in the pelvis, they tend to crisscross each other as they have to divide it into two to go to either leg. And in that process, the artery, which is high-pressure system, can compress the vein.
When the vein is compressed, it restricts the blood flow and can cause a deep vein thrombosis, a life-threatening blood clot. Dr. Kim says conventional CT scans, ultrasounds, and MRIs have not been effective in diagnosing May-Thurner, but a new method is.
We have an ultrasound as small as this. It's a sort of, I'm going to compare this to, it's my last finger, and that's how thin they are. We insert this into the vein that goes up all the way up to the pelvic vein and see how collapsed they are in relation to the artery. And if they are collapsed more than 50%, that's diagnostic for May-Thurner disease.
Dr. Kim treats the condition with a stent, and improvement with blood flow is immediate. On the left is a vein before stent surgery, on the right, after. Dr. Kim also recommends patients use this leg compression device several times a day to maintain the health of the vein. Dolores had the stent surgery and says the difference is night and day.
Now I can get up, I can do my daily chores, you know, I can go to work, and everything is fine now. And I have my health and strength back, and that was most important to me.
Mindy Becerra, WBAL TV 11 News.